What is artificial intelligence?
The ability to store data, process data, and make meaningful relations.
Ability to perceive, learn, and reason.
But the learning is not the intelligence by itself.
What's intelligence? And that's the far more difficult one of these two questions.
Artificial intelligence is not new. The idea was actually conceived back in the 1950s.
The world was created in 1955 by McCarthy.
Artificial intelligence was one way of describing turns that were happening beginning in the 1950s and 60s with the advance of digital computing and the belief that they would be able to provide more intelligent, autonomous decision making.
In 1955 was a moment where people were really expected to create general artificial intelligence.
We have general AI if we have machines that are genuinely intelligent in the sense in which we think of ourselves as intelligent, as being able to deal with a wide, broad variety of cases and a broad variety of different tasks. We don't have anything like that.
So current artificial intelligence is a collection of machine learning techniques, big data analysis that allows us essentially to see patterns in a way that we couldn't see patterns before.
Narrow AI are systems that can do very particular tasks. Prediction and classification. That's where these systems shine right now.
It was really during the past few decades because of the huge development in hardware, the networks, the internet, the great sensors, and the huge storages that enables us to collect and store oceans of the data and analyze them in a very efficient manner.
I mean, one of the reasons why AI is very popular these days, it's also because we have a vast amount of data available. Nowadays, everything can be online, so it's easy, quote, to apply an unsupervised learning algorithm and then let the algorithm say, you know, find patterns in those billions of images and then tell us, you know, what makes the difference between someone with a cancer or someone with cancer.
So it's not going to be anymore about some traditional way of using computers when we are just doing some routine work, some calculations, some data management or documentation. It goes beyond that. It's to have the capability to reason and learn.
And in order to do that, we need a number of techniques. So when we talk about deep learning or when we talk about neural networks, they are mechanisms through which artificial intelligence capabilities can be developed.
So artificial intelligence is the idea of how can we make things think. Machine learning is how to apply mathematics to that problem.
So machine learning is talking about is the machine trying to learn things. But there is so many ways to learn a thing. Just like human, different people, different students have different ways of learning the same topic. Some of them may try to memorize it. Some of them may try to find out certain patterns. Some of them may try to learn from doing a set of questions.
We want to come up with rule-based algorithms that over time they learn using the different source of data. So here we're working with big data. So this data is going to be analyzed and used, and the machine is learning over time how to come up with, you know, reasoning approaches, how to come up with learning approaches.
And deep learning is applying actually a specific type of mathematics where you try to mimic the brain function through mathematical function to create artificial intelligence.
Deep learning over there is more or less similar to doing a set of questions. It's trying to mimic our brain design. Because our brain is not a single layer connection. We have very complex connection of that. Then that is called the deep learning. It's just a way of machine learning. You need to learn and then adapt and then to apply, to infer to other domain. Then that is the intelligence. And so far, this is a quite attractive and interesting topic for learning.